મેમ રેકોર્ડિંગ સ્ટાર્ટ થઈ ગયું છે.
હેલો
હા દમિત બોલ.
યસ નિકુંજ સર, કેન યુ સ્ટાર્ટ
હિયરિંગ માય વોઇસ? હેલો.
હા યસ મેમ.
તો નિકુંજ સર, કેન વી સ્ટાર્ટ ડાયરેક્ટલી? રાઈટ,
યસ, રેકોર્ડિંગ સ્ટાર્ટેડ મેમ.
ઓકે ફાઇન. સો હિયર આઈ વુડ લાઈક ટુ વેલકમ રિસ્પેક્ટેડ ટ્રસ્ટીઝ ઓફ વિદ્યા ભારતી ટ્રસ્ટ ઇન્સ્ટિટ્યુશન. એમ આઈ ઓડિબલ સર?
યસ મેમ.
Respected trustees of Vidya Bharati Trust Institution, respected principal Dr. Piyush Jain sir, our civil department head respected Kiru Shah sir, our all civil engineering department faculty members, all dear students, and but obvious our speaker Dr. Bansri Dave ma'am. I am Dr. Damayanti Badkar, training and placement officer of S.N. Patel Institute of Technology and Research Center Umrak. Welcome you all on behalf of our institute. As we know that AICT-GTU doing a lot of hard work for students' improvement, their knowledge enhancement activities, and such things are really very useful for students for their career advancement. So by keeping that point in view, our S.N. Patel Institute of Technology and Research Center Umrak, with a training and placement cell for civil engineering students, organized this webinar with the Dr. Bansri ma'am. So before we are going for the speaker introduction, we would like to give little glimpse of institute profile. Like a Vidya Bharati Trust is the name associated with education for more than 3 decades near Bardoli of Surat district, and has now evolved as a symbol of quality education dedicated to nurture the talent and aspiration of the bright youth of your nation. Vidya Bharati Trust, our institute having our Vidya Bharati Trust institution having BBA, BCA, BEd, MCA, Pharmacy, Diploma Studies, and definitely our Degree Engineering College, SNPIT and RC Umrak. Here we are offering graduate course in Chemical Engineering Department, in Civil Engineering Department, in Computer Science and Engineering Department, in Electrical Engineering Department, in EC Engineering Department, and in Mechanical Engineering Department. Here we are having a post-graduation courses in ME Civil Construction Engineering Management, and in any mechanical production engineering courses. So with the glorious introduction of our institute, I would like to request Nikunj sir, please you proceed for further. So then we will give the introduction of speaker, and then we can start this webinar, sir. Yes, Nikunj sir. Hello.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Nikunj sir, if Kiyur sir with us and sir would like to address us with a few words, then we will welcome our department head.
Yeah, I think Kiyur sir is in the cabin right now.
Okay, fine. Okay, fine. So we will start with the speaker introduction, and then we proceed for the webinar. Right? Okay, sir. So Dr. Bansri Dave ma'am is an associate professor in a Nobel group of institution. Madam having a teaching and industry experience more than 16 years. She has completed her PhD from CP University Kota. Ma'am completed her ME Construction Technology from RK University Kota. Ma'am is a member of Internal Association of Engineers, Institute of Research Engineers, and doctorate. Ma'am also dealing with like consulting, she is also doing some work like consulting engineer in Nascent Associates in Rajkot. So madam published more than 16 research paper in different journal and attended lots of faculty development program for career advancement. Ma'am delivered more than 20 lecture in a national and international platform. So here with this glorious resume and bio data, we will welcome our speaker Dr. Bansri ma'am to give knowledge and share her expertise with our students. Thank you, ma'am.
Thanks for the privilege. Thank you, Damayanti madam. So Shall I start now?
Yes.
Hello. Okay. Are you able to see the screen properly or?
Ma'am, we are not able to see the screen.
Just a minute.
Ma'am, we are able to see your webcam, but we are not able to see any screen. Please share the screen if you are sharing any.
Should I go for presentation? I think.
Yeah, ma'am. You can click on present now. Yeah. And you can select the window.
Yeah, I got it. Yeah. I got it. I think it is being shared now. Is it visible?
Yeah, ma'am. Now it's coming.
Okay. So, just a minute. Okay. So now, I hope I'm audible. You all say yes?
Yes, ma'am.
Hello. Okay. Okay. So now, when we come to the topic, there are many questions arising in our mind, right? So today's topic is coin as a mineral addition in concrete production, right? Hello, are you getting it properly? Hello? 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 Am I audible?
Ma'am, your voice is breaking.
Maybe hello.
Maybe some network issue or anything. Your voice is breaking.
Okay. Just a minute.
Okay, ma'am. Perfect.
Yes. Is it audible?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So fine, let's start with the topic. Actually, alkafine is a mineral admixture and in concrete production is today's topic. So as well, you know about my designation. So I did my M.Tech in construction technology. I did study on rigid pavement by using alkafine concrete itself, right? So I am related with alkafine right from the beginning, right from the M.Tech itself. I used IRC 5844 and 15, used software CanPave for rigid pavement design and PAD, an experimental study of design of multi-storied building by using HPC, used software ETAPS STAD Pro for multi-storied building design and analysis. And I used LaTeX for typesetting with standard format and editing, right? So these are some content outline, introduction necessity and all this. So we come to the introduction now, right? So now when we come to the topic, there are many questions arises in our mind, isn't it? Like what is alkafine, types of alkafine and uses of alkafine, right? So that you already heard about some mineral admixtures like fly ash, silica fume, and GGBS, metaxolin, right? These are common mineral admixtures, but the name is a little new, alkafine, right? It's a new for newly entered students, right? But it's far famous in industry, construction industry. It is far famous. So Alkafine is a very common and very important name when we are doing some work related to concrete, high performance concrete, right? So now during this session, we are not going to discuss about mostly discussed and known topics. We shall try to collect new, or I can say latest information, which can make the platform of curiosity larger and larger. I also hope you have pen and page, or at least fingers to get this screenshot, right? So shall we start now, students? Okay. So we start from mineral admixtures. These are basic information, and it is important to know that in general, admixtures defined as material other than basic ingredients of concrete. Now we know about the basic ingredients of concrete. So added to the concrete immediately before or during the mixing process to modify the property of concrete, right? So generally, why we are using admixtures? To accelerate, to retard the process, water reducing agents and air entraining, and super plasticizing. And very common are fly ash, microsilica, and GGBS, so common names, right? So I have collected some images to make the presentation interesting. Fly ash, coal-fired power plants, right? You've seen or you have been visited during your study, or right? GGBS, ground granulated blast furnace slag, and OPC. This is the packing and image of packing, right?
Then,
yes, hello?
Yeah, sorry to interrupt you. But yeah. Are you changing the slides in your presentation mode?
Yeah, I'm changing my
slides. Actually, your basic PowerPoint window is being shared, not the one of the presentation. That is, I guess you had clicked F5. It's showing that you have started the presentation.
Yeah.
But on the screen, we are able to see your first slide. That is in edit mode. Your PPT screen edit mode is visible. So once again, if you want to share, see, now you, I guess you have moved 11 slides, but we were on the first slide itself in sharing the screen.
Okay, now it's getting changed?
Yeah, now it's getting changed. Like when you start the presentation mode, you will have to again select present now, and then you will have to present the window of presentation mode. Or you can share that your entire screen, then it will be visible easily in big screen.
If I'm sharing my entire screen, I'm not able to see anything. Let me try it once.
Yeah, ma'am. Once try it out.
Stop presenting. Okay.
Present now in your entire screen.
Entire screen. Okay. And now I think I should change the slides and start presentation.
I guess your entire screen is not visible here.
This is the same thing I did right from the beginning. Okay, there's some problem, I don't know.
Okay, then first, ma'am, on your desktop, start your presentation mode. And then again, shift to this Google Meet, and then present now, and select the window of presentation mode. Then we will be able to see the presentation mode.
Okay, I started presentation, right?
Yeah.
And now,
present now a window, and in that select the presentation mode of your PPT.
Then I go to window, na?
Yeah.
Okay, window, and then slideshow.
Yeah, slideshow.
Okay. And share.
Yeah.
Okay. Is it visible now?
Yes, ma'am.
It started with microsilica itself.
Yeah, so you can shift if you want.
Yeah, other slides. Yeah, I can shift to. Okay. Okay. But my slides are not getting changed.
Here also it is not getting changed. Your microsilica slide is only stable here. It's stuck to microsilica.
Okay, now it's getting changed. Okay.
Yes.
Are you able to see?
Yes.
Okay, thank you. Okay, thanks for the info, Hira. And now some images I'm sharing, like fly ash, that is coal-fired power plants. You have been visited during your study. GGBS, that is ground granulated blast furnace leg. This is its packing. And you can see the images and powder foam of GGBS and OPC. OPC, that is ordinary Portland cement. Then microsilica, or we can say silica fume, right? It's powder foam and its packings available in market. You can see the packings, right? These are all products. See, these are all products. These are all admixtures. It's available in India Mart itself also. And you can directly buy it from the company itself or get it from the plants itself, right? Then metakaolin. It's a foam, powder foam, and packing. Then rice husk ash. So these are different types of rice husk ash. You can see the different foams and images. Sticky, red, brown, raw rice husk, rice husk ash, then SiO2. These are different images. And some images I collected from some different institutes to get more information about. Copper slag and basalt fiber for green concrete. Then carbon black for eco-friendly cement mortar. Right? Ceramic waste powder for low-cost concrete. See, many admixtures are being used for different purposes. Right? So we have been visiting with the main or very common admixtures. And now we switch to alkofine. What is the material alkofine? First come first question comes in our mind, that is, what is alkofine? So alkofine generally it's a when we come to the topic, there are many questions arises in our mind, that is, what is alkofine, types of alkofine, and uses of alkofine, right? So that we already heard about fly ash, silica fume, microsilica, GGBS, etc. See, if I'm not audible, please inform me, right? But the name can be a little new for the newly entered student, but it's far famous in the construction industry. It's alkofine. Types of alkofine we can discuss, like there are some codes 1203. It's being used for concrete, high performance concrete. The older version was 1200, I think. And one more version is there, 1101, that's being used for grouting, right? So alkofine 1203 is the latest ultra fine material. It has low calcium silicate. It has noticeable properties to enhance performance of concrete in fresh and hardened state. See, why we are using alkofine? It should be better than rest of the materials. So this is the main thing why we are using alkofine. So I have got the image of Lafarge Holcim Innovation Center. It's situated in France. And nowadays it is alkofine material is available in India also. Alkofine is a Ambuja Cements product. So this one is the world's largest R&D center for building materials and processes. Right? Many researchers, including a maximum proportion of PhD holders, are also doing better research work, and they have got 250 and more than 250 patents, I think, right? So this is some images. These are some interesting things. Okay, some interesting facts about concrete. So concrete is a heterogeneous material that changes its state from solid to liquid or plastic to solid without any external source of energy. It's very common. We know very well that it changes its states and it doesn't use external source of energy, right? So concrete is quite interesting and the processes we know, it's a little complicated, but it's quite interesting, and it creates miracles when it works according to our plan, right? So concrete performance expectation, how much we expect from concrete and its performance, right? We are creating a material, but our it should be according to our expectation, right? So in during plastic state of concrete, it should be cohesive, no bleed, will not segregate, will not set fast, will not set late, will harden fast after placement, right? Why we need it to set fast and should not set late? So we need enough workability during the transportation of the concrete, right? These are basic things you must be knowing. Hardened state will not shrink, will not crack, dimensionally stable, fast strength gain, early deshuttering, right? We need to remove the shuttering and all in order to save some money and time and all this stuff, right? So these are our expectations during hardened state. 28 days strength in 7 days, like all the strength we need, or 3 days or 1 day. Those are, it should be like rapid hardening type of. Then long-term expectations, it should resist all weather conditions, will not leak, remain stable and strong. Aesthetics of beauty, no maintenance cost, will last for generations, right? We need our structures for long and long generations, right? So now the main important thing, that is cement hydration process. When we are considering some admixtures, we should focus on hydration process of cement. The main components being participated in this process are silicates, allite, C3S 70% in cement compound, and bellite, that is C2S 16%, aluminates A, tricalcium aluminate C3A 8%, ferrite C4AF 7%, sulfates, gypsum dehydrate, hemihydrate, anhydrate, and it combines with H2O. When hydration starts, when it combines with H2O. In dry state C, it's very interesting. In dry state, there is no chemical reaction. But when it combines with water, say H2O, exothermic, it gives some products like hydration products. Calcium silicate hydrates, 48%. Calcium hydroxide, CaOH, 14%. Atrangite, CaSH, 11%. Monosulfate, 4%. And pores, 16%. We'll elaborate in next slides, right? So heat evolution rates. Generally, what happens when we are using plain cement, heat goes up, right? And we know it's generating high heat, okay? So initially, for 10 to 15 minutes, it's not that much heat, and it stays for 2-3 hours, and later on, for 1 or 2 days, it's being accelerated, right? The reactions are being accelerated, C3S hydration starts, and it gives high heat, right? Then it decreases when C3A hydration starts. Then it slows down, and continuous slowdown process is there as well. We know continuously hydration is there in concrete, right? So there are some other graphs also this side. And we can see yellow is a cement mix design only, and blue shows some admixtures, and it shows that the heat of hydration is being lowered when we are using admixtures, right? But then we should take care that the proportion should be the exit and heat of hydration should be considered while we are using different types of admixtures. Okay, we have seen this graph, and you can see now the hydrated cement paste. So the brighter person is unhydrated. Okay, when when hydration process takes place, it produces CSH gel, right? And gel covers the whole area of unhydrated cement, and it becomes a strong layer, right? So these are on the next side. It shows bilites, B shows A shows elites, and P shows pores, right? So elites are brighter, bilites are a little darker, right? And pores are purely dark. So these are some SEM images. Now the benefit of Alkufine's CaO content. What is the CaO content, and how does it play its role during hydration process, right? So what is special? We can ask that what is special in Alkufine? So special is its inbuilt CaO content, right? Alkufine 1203 targets two-way actions during hydration. First is primary reaction of cement hydration. Second is pozzolanic reaction. So hydraulic and pozzolanic reaction action is OPC plus H2O, right? So initially it starts combining with water, OPC plus H2O. It creates CSH gel, right? And CaOH2. There is carbon calcium hydroxide that is weaker in strength, where the formation of CSH provides strong bond with aggregates, and it gives good strength. And CaOH2 is weak powder. CSH forms a strong paste to bond all aggregates together. Now CaOH2 combines in next cycle. CaOH2 combines with alkufine, fly ash, or microsilica, any admixtures I can say, and it produces CSH gel. That is the miracle of inbuilt CaO content of alkufine. So finally, we are getting, because of production of CSH gel, we are getting good strength, right? Now the advantage of alkufine. So in comparison with other admixtures like silica fume, metakaolin, type of fly ash, these are all pozzolanic, and it gives pozzolanic reaction. And whereas in alkufine you can see the fourth layer, that is again hydraulic reaction, right? So it gives further strength to the concrete. And these are some graph. You can see more portion of SiO2 in silica fume. Alkufine is having some portion of CaO, some portion of SiO2, Al2O3, right? So it's a mixture of all materials, right? Advantage of alkufine showing the dense importance of making paste with cement. Now, maintained alkalinity of pore solution with the alkufine 1203. Right? Here we are discussing about alkufine 1203. Right? Because it is being used for concrete itself, and we are going to discuss with the about the mineral admixtures, right? So CaO content in OPC is 63%, as well, you know, it is 60 to 63% in OPC, right? CaO content in alkufine 1203 is what? That is 34%, and its CaO inbuilt CO, right? So C3S plus H2O, it becomes CSH, and again CaOH2, that is calcium hydroxide, combines with silica and it gives CSH. The CaO available in 1-0-3 contribute to maintain CaOH as buffer in pore solution, right? So it maintains pH, denser pore matrix, restricts chloride penetration. Further, it gives a better benefit, that is, it restricts chloride penetration, and alkalinity forms passive layer on steel and protects the it from corrosion, right? So alkofine, it gives so many benefits, like it stops corrosion and maintains pH. It produces buffer, COH as a buffer in post solution. So these are benefits of using alkofine and ITZ improvement. Now, what is ITZ and how it alkofine works to improve this? So in normal concrete, the transition zone, you know, the transition zone is a thin layer of about 50 to 100 microns length between the bulk hydrated cement. You can see the image here. These are cement particles. These are we consider it as cement particles, and these are some materials or fillers, we can say, or pozzolan materials filled in between, right? So between the bulk hydrated cement paste and the surface of aggregate particles in concrete is the weakest and highly permeable due to uniformly sized cement grains, which are not densely packed, right? Okay, we consider this one is aggregate, okay? And these are cement particles again, and presence of ultrafine cementous material. These are all ultrafine cementous material. Addition of ultrafine particles in this image, you can see ultrafine material is added. In this red image is red spots are showing ultrafine material, right? So presence of ultrafine cementous pozzolanic materials allows denser packing between cement particles and reduces the wall effect in transition zone between the paste and the aggregate. So it reduces the pore structure and it gives a dense particle packing, right? So this is how the alkofine works, and alkofine is well graded and it gives good packing effect, right? Then typical particle size distribution. See, PSD plays very important role when you are deciding admixture for a particular concrete, right? So when it comes to cement, how much is the size? So we can say it's 20 microns. Let's see, the upper one is a cement particle in this image, and alkofine 1-0-3 is 4 microns. But we should remember that it's well graded and it has a proper grading, right? And silica fume is 0.5 microns size. So particle size distribution is shown in this image with OPC, percentage passing microns, right? Typical particle size distribution is being discussed in this. New images will discuss and elaborate more about PSD in alkofine. Approved quality plan for 1-0-3. See, now we can see the particle size distribution in alkofine 1-0-3. So this one is a quality plan. I've collected some images from net. So particle size distribution D10. D10, what does it mean? D10 should be less than 2 micron. That is 10% of particles should be less than 2 microns in a particular quantity or particular volume, right? So, and D50 is less than 5 microns. D90, that is, it should be less than 9 microns. D100, that is, it should be less than 20 microns. So these are grading of alkofine 1203. And now we come to chemical composition. So SiO2 is 30 to 34%, Al2O3 21 to 25%, Fe2O3 0.8 to 2.1%, and CaO we just discussed, that is 30 to 33%, or we can say 34%. SO2 that is 0.2 to 0.5%, magnesium oxide MgO 6 to 10%. And now third one is compressive strength of concrete, that is improved workability. This when we are using alkofine, it gives improved workability, improved workability retention, improved compressive strength, right? So tested with respect to microsilica or metakaolin as 10% replacement of total cementous content or in M60, we are getting this much benefits, right? Now particle range. So it is generally considered that fineness of cement ore and cementous materials have influence on strength. Definitely, it gives good impact on strength. Besides fineness, the particle size distribution, shape, surface nature play significant role in strength and performance. Right, so particle size distribution is shown in this next image. Microsilica is a blue one, this one is microsilica, and the pink one is alkofine. So it gives a good grading over here. We can see maximum proportion like from 5 to 50 microns, I think. It gives good grading. Alkofine has particle range 0.1 to 17 microns, means less than 5 micron, right? So now advantages of alkofine in concrete. It improves workability, workability retention, flowability as well, we know, and we have discussed. So now, and also it improves rheology. It doesn't compromise with the rheological properties with of concrete, and it gives better result. It gives better strength in comparison with other admixtures. It reduces segregation. It reduces heat of hydration. We have seen the charts in earlier images, right? Hardened state, it improves durability, improves resistance to ASR, right? And it improves strength at all ages. It improves resistance to chemical attack, corrosion. It imparts light color, lowers permeability, right? Because of its well-graded particles, it lowers the permeability. It reduces voids and so many benefits. So these advantages are due to hydraulic activity, microstructure, and pore solution composition and space diameter. So now chloride permeability as per ASTM 1543. See, because of having dense paste of alkofine concrete, chloride penetration can be reduced, providing resistance to corrosion, right? And next is calcium oxide content of alkofine, that is alkofine 1203, provides maintaining calcium hydroxide as buffer in pores, which maintain pH in pore structure. So now we have collected some ACM images at equal magnifications. Densified silica fumes, this has been 1,000 times larger than the actual. And next is processed fly ash. You can see more dark in this fly ash image, metakaolin and ultrafine slate. Now you can see ultrafine slate. It's a good material, and that is very near to nanomaterial, you can see, right? Because of its fineness. Okay, there are some more images. It's not readable, but it's quite interesting to see the images of SEM and get the information about particles and voids, right? तो जिस देर आर सम मोर इमेजेस द SEM माइक्रोग्राफ्स ऑफ मिनरल एडिटिव्स आर प्रेजेंटेड इन द फिगर्स इमेज फॉर ईच मटेरियल एट मैग्निफिकेशन 1000 टाइम्स आर प्रेजेंटेड इज फ्रॉम दिस इमेजेस आर बीइंग रिसर्च्ड फ्रॉम IIT मद्रास एंड फर्स्ट इमेज शोज कंडेंस्ड सिलिका फ्यूम एंड इट्स पार्टिकल्स आर मोर of spherical and metakaolin angular particles and then fly ash dust 60 and then it comes alcofine 1203 is the finest material. It gives a good fineness, right? Okay. Now microfine, ultrafine basic principles. So what happens when we consider an element volume or volume to specific surface area, like it is 1 meter by 1 meter by 1 meter, right? So surface, what will be the surface area of a particular thing, that is 6 meter square for one element, it's if you consider, right? Four of this side and two plus sides, that is 6 meter square is its surface area, right? Now we are dividing this particular element to four more cubes, right? So what happens to the surface area? It will become 12 meter square, right? Again we are dividing it into more cubes. It gives 0.25 by 0.25 by 0.25, then surface area will be 24 meter square. So this is how we can increase the surface area and how the ultra fine material gives us good particle packing effect, right? So now it's easier for you to know definitions of ultrafine and microfine material as per Indian standard 16715. See, in our IS it is very clearly written that D95 less than 15 microns and D50 means what we discussed, that is 50% of particles should be less than 5 microns, right? And 95% of particles should be less than 15 microns is considered as ultrafine material as per IS 16715. Now SEI committee 552, as per SEI committee 552, and the European SFS EN 12715 D95 should be less than 20 micrometer. Sorry. Norwegian purpose, two groups, D95 less than 30 micrometer microfine and D95 less than 15 micrometer ultrafine. Practice D95 less than 6 micrometer. Right. Then the terminology D95 we already discussed. If you don't want to, that is, this one is a PSD particle size distribution. It is the most important parameter along with reactivity of alkaline additives to achieve maximum packing density. Right. Now this one is a PSD report. We need to know, and we have some of the report we have discussed, so we need not to discuss it again. Comparison of PSD curve, see, these are blue lines shows OPC curve, and the green one is showing ultrafine leg, and ultrafine leg is showing good particle packing properties. It gives up to 60 to 80% is a good graph is showing in ultrafine slate, right? and comparison of materials. So we have, I think, very few time now left for the discussion. Composition of various materials. So OPC, it's CO, as well we know, its CO content is 60 to 67%, SiO2, 18 to 22%, Al2O3, 3 to 6%, Fe2O3, 1 to 4%, LOI, 1.4%, pH less is greater than 12. Whereas in microsilica, we discuss or we directly compare it with ultrafine slag. So CO content we know 32 to 34%, SiO2 28 to 32%, Al2O3 18 to 20%, Fe2O3 1.8 to 2%, LOI matters a lot, and it's 0.8 to 1.3%, right? It's performance with comparison with OPC. Okay, and pH is 12 to 14. Pozzolanic reactivity, filler reactive, not reactive, or alkoxide CaSO3. These are some more questions. Let we switch to next slide, that is pozzolanic reaction. So now you can see the image of dry portion in concrete during hydration process. There are some additives added into and when we are adding alkoxide, what it gives the effect, that is it gives good packing effect, right? So pozzolanic reaction is discussed here. OPC plus H2O, CSH plus CaOH2, and again CaOH2 combines with SCM, microfine SCM, it gives CSH, and again it gives a good strength as we discussed earlier, right? So particle packing density concept, how does it work? We have discussed more CH is formed in discontinuous pore structure because of alkoxide as a mineral admixtures, and it's a well-graded material. It gives good strength by providing good density, right? And now this one is a alkoxide magic trick. This one is cement particles, and how the ultrafine powder is packed with. This one is the granular packing density impact. So lighter way to explain is how the particle packing works. We can consider this Motichur laddu with besan laddu, and we can imagine how the laddus are breaking and how the how dense structure is in between these two. Okay, now combined particle size distribution of binders is important for improvement of rheological behavior of concrete. When we are discussing about cement ultrafine material, that is a very good contribution in the 5 to 50 micron range by the higher fraction of ultrafine slag. Now in next image, it is apparent that contribution is in the 10 to 50 micron range because of densified particles of microsilica. The second is showing about microsilica, and see the difference in between ultrafine slag, that is alkoxide, and microsilica, right? So optimum particle packing of binders is depend on particle size distribution first, right, of all binders, including that of cement, particle shape and size of binders, chemical and mineral mineralogical composition, loss on ignition, uniformity, consistency, dosage of proportion. So these are these many things. It depends on this, not only PSD, but it includes all the stuffs. And it should be taken care of. Impact on heat of hydration. Now, if we are using plain cement, it gives high heat. As we discussed, the yellow line shows that is pure OPC, and the green line, you can see the difference. Like it gives heat of hydration very low, right? The green line is showing very low heat of hydration. So you can see in this graph itself. So now the lime reactivity test and the chloride permeability. Okay, so you can discuss ultra fine slag. Lime content is 0.32 in comparison with let's say silica fume 0.34, and pozzolanic content 0.74, and this one is 0.75. Water content, see the difference. Water content required in this ultra fine slag is very less than silica fume and metakaolin, both the things. And we can see the strength because of less water content. So river sand is used and flow in mm is given. So comparisons of compressive strength in one day, UFS is giving 20.5 and silica fume is giving 9.9. So we can see the difference in strength also. Chloride penetration, top surface 0.3 when we are using ultra fine slag, right? So it gives 0.3 only. And chloride contains for OPC, concrete control material, that is 0.4. Okay. And now if we are going up to 35 mm depth, it gives 0.0048, which is far better. When we are using ultra fine slag, that is alkofine, it gives far better result than OPC. It gives 0.11. Okay. So these are the basic difference, and sometimes it is given some proportions, like you should use fly ash in replacement of cement 15 to 30%, GGBS 25 to 50%, metakaolin 5 to 15%, silica fume 5 to 10%. But as per the sources or information from experts, it should be considered with weight and volume. Like you can check the weight and volume. Total binder is 520 and microfine is 10%, that is 52. Now, if you are using 52 kilogram, and if you are changing it with fly ash or any other material, you can say microsilica, you cannot use direct 52 kilogram. You should consider the SC, right? Specific gravity, because it differs. Microsilica, it has 2.2. And the volume 52 kilogram gives 24 liter, right? So we cannot directly use any material without considering its specific gravity. Like if we are replacing UFS ultra fine slag, then it is its specific gravity is 2.86 and it becomes 18 liter, right? Metakaolin, it becomes 21 liter because its specific gravity is 2.5. This way UFFA and RHA, we should consider 24 and 25. Now, what is efficiency factor? See, what is efficiency factor? If you are using ultrafine slag, replacing cement, then what happens? See, you should use ultra fine slag as a 2 to 4. You should consider efficiency factor as a 2 to 4. We'll discuss it in next slide. Variations in mixed design. See, variations you can consider OPC, fly ash, water, fine, coarse, chemical, and air. So in general, you consider 380, right? And when you are using it with alkofine, or you can say UFS, ultrafine slag, how much is it gives? It gives 360, okay? You are saving cement up to 360, and you are using fly ash instead, and UFS. Water content, it gives 159. In comparison with this 158, and here we are using 162 water. Okay, Then course aggregate 1050, 1050, 1080 and chemical 5, okay, and 6.5 and 4. So when we are comparing it with alkoxyfene, it gives a better result and better proportion of rest of the material, and overall we are saving cement, right? So indirectly it affects the environment also, right? Now practical mixes. So how we find the practical mixes? Generally, because we are using microfine material is now available in market, so we need not to go for costly materials, right? So in this case, OPC we are using 430, fly ash GGBS 100, microfine 30, slump it gives 180, and compressive strength is 34, 50, and 78. This one is, I think, 1D strength, and it gives 34. Sorry. And in the second, if you are using 5% of mix, then it gives 40%. And in some mixes, it gives, okay, in this one, it gives better result. And water retain, water penetration less than 10 mm. Okay, chloride penetration not applicable. So if you are using 3% of particles, it gives high saving in OPC, I think. And it's 130, I think the image is disturbed, I think. And fly ash, you are using 300. So when you are using 3% of particle, you're saving more cement, right? And it gives a better result. Okay. Now, we switch to some more information. In Qatar lab, Lafarge Holcim ready mix in Qatar, right? So this one is to reduce the CM, chloride migration, less than 2. So when it was required to less than 2 chloride migration in corrosive environment of Qatar, some experiment was done. Like in this OPC was used 100%. But the chloride migration was 6.71, sorry. And when we were using ultrafine slag, right, in combination with GGBS, if alkoxyfene is used, we have reduced in the next to last is 2.5, and the last one finally we got less than 2, that is 1.98, right? There are some examples of alkoxyfene 1203 in 200 Samsung Korea, right? M200. Right? So these are some packings of alkoxyfene, and price of alkoxyfene is about 27 per kilogram, and bulk so what are microfine cement as an additive? So many of us are aware of microfine cement. So microfine cement is now available in India also. Some part of cement remains unhydrated. We have already discussed. The lighter part is unhydrated part, and it becomes a solid state when it gets hardened. So greater chance of more hydrate with MFC. What happens when we are using MFC, it makes four part of the structure, and because it gives more area, it gives good hydration, and this way MFC is playing a good role during hydration, right? So now challenges while using ultrafine slag, or you can say alkoxyfene as a admixture. So it should be consistent, PSD, right? And alloy plays a big role, moisture content should be maintained during all mix, right? And operational dosing and mixing, how it mixes, like if you are mixing it with 2000 kilogram or more than that, the batches are different, but it should be mixed properly and homogeneously. If some portion is having alkaline content and some portion is not having the proper mix, then it gives poor result, right? So these are the challenges we have to face during this. And sometimes it becomes tough to pass with on a bed conveyor because of its fineness. So combined impact of all ingredients, that is OPC, JGBS, OPC, fly ash, high volume SCMs, OPC fineness, dusty, clean sand, admixture compatibility. Like some admixtures are suitable with alkaline, some admixtures are suitable with OPC. So we have to go and look after all those things and see the results, and then only we decide for particular admixtures. Health and environment, dust and crystalline silica. Crystalline silica is very problematic for human, right? So these are the things, these are the challenges. Now, what is the conclusions? For proper particle packing, ultrafine materials have to be used in conjunction with different materials. So shape and size, as well as distribution, PSD of finer ultrafine materials play an important role in workability, cohesiveness, and pumpability. Fine and ultrafine materials play a very important role to strengthen the interface between the binder's paste and the aggregates. Free water and entrapped air get reduced in binder paste when fine and ultrafine materials are used. This reduces shrinkage. Mixing has to be done properly when ultrafine materials are used. So, and the next is durability and strength are greatly enhanced if fine and ultrafine materials are used in concrete. UFS helps develop green and sustainable construction. These are conclusion I can give you. And Goodreads are, if you want to go for more information, measuring water demand or packing density of micro powders, comparison methods, Sonja Fanis, Deaf University of Technology, SAAM Fanis. You should go through this first one, and the second one is chloride migration coefficient from non-steady state migration experiments, anti-built 492. So these are the good reads for you. And very much thank you to Mr. Yatin Joseph, project manager, Lafarge Halsim, for the presentation AC. And thank you, SNPIT. Thank you, Damayanti Madam. So the presentation is over. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Dear students, do you have any doubts? Then you can just unmute your mics and you can ask your questions to ma'am.
Yeah, please.
Or you can just write in chat section. Anyone? Okay. So thank you so much, ma'am, for your wonderful session.
Yes, thank you very much. Thank you.
To make aware our students regarding this alkaline as a mineral admixture in Indic concrete production, I will take privilege to convey word of thanks to speaker Dr. Bansi Dave ma'am for sparing your valuable time and your busy from your busy schedule. I would also like to thank our Vidyapati Trust, our principal Dr. Piyush Jain sir, our department head Mr. K.U. Shah sir, our trainee and placement officer Dr. Damayanti Burga ma'am for organizing this event. I also like to thank our training and placement team, all faculty members for the help, support, and for their successful execution of this program. Thank you, dear students and other audience for joining this session. Thank you. Here our session is closed. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.
Here concluding our session. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you.